हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी श्री आरएलटी कॉलेज ऑफ साइंस अकोला। आई एम डॉक्टर अर्चना सावरकर, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी। स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम ऑफ द एनिमल एम्फियोक्सिस। Before going to excretory system in detail, we should know about some vital processes, life processes of any organism. For example, digestion, circulation, respiration, reproduction, and excretion, all these are the vital processes in living organisms. So, in this lecture, we have to study about excretion. Excretion is the process by which metabolic waste is eliminated from the body of organism. Before going to excretory system in detail, we should know the organs of excretion. What is the meaning of excretory organs? The organs which help in the process of removal of nitrogenous waste or the metabolic waste product from the body are called as excretory organs. Generally, in chordates, kidney is an excretory organ. These kidneys are mesodermal in origin. While excretory organ of this branchiostoma or amphioxus are entirely different. In case of amphioxus, nephridia are the excretory organ and they are ectodermal in origin. This is the basic difference in between chordates and amphioxus about the excretory organ. These ectodermal nephridia have no relation with the mesoderm in amphioxus. Thus, they are different from the kidney of vertebrates, which are mesodermal in origin. These excretory organs are closely resemble with the protonephridia of flatworm or polychaete annelids, and thus it provides a very good example of parallel evolution. Some other organs as well as cells are also regarded to be excretory in case of amphioxus. These are some excretory organs. The first and most important is protonephridia. Then Hatchett's nephridium, brown funnel, then renal papillae. These are the main excretory organ in amphioxus. Let us see one by one. The protonephridia of amphioxus are simple, closed, ciliated, sac-like and thin-walled ectodermal tubules. You can observe here the position of protonephridia where they are present. You have already seen the digestive system of amphioxus. This is the position of pharynx. This large bag-like structure is a pharynx. And this is the lateral side of pharynx. On both lateral side of the pharynx, protonephridia are present. Means they are dorsolateral in position on both wall of the pharynx. And how many protonephridia are present? Near about 90 to 100 pairs of protonephridia are present on dorsolateral pharyngeal wall, one above each gill slit on either side. This is the position of this protonephridia. Now, if we enlarge this much portion of the pharynx, the position as well as structure of protonephridia will be clear. We will enlarge this portion here. This is the wall of pharynx. This is anterior region and posterior region. You can observe here number of gill slits on the wall of pharynx. These are the gill slits which are divided by primary as well as secondary gill bars. This is primary gill bar and this one is secondary gill bar, alternate with each other. And on the dorsolateral side of pharynx, there are presence of this protonephridia. This bent structure are the protonephridia. How many protonephridia are there? Near about 90 to 100 pairs of protonephridia are present on both lateral side of the pharynx of Amphioxus. Here you can observe this bent structure have two limbs. This is the vertical limb and this one is the horizontal limb. This vertical limb of protonephridia lies in the coelomic canal of primary gill bar, while the horizontal limb, it is present in the dorsal coelomic canal and this end is opened by this opening. The vertical limb is closed while the horizontal limb, it opens by this opening. We will see the detailed structure of protonephridia in next slide. Let us see the structure of single protonephridia. It is simple, close, ciliated, sac-like and thin-walled ectodermal tubule. Here you can observe this protonephridia bears two limbs. In the anterior position, this is vertical limb, anterior vertical limb of protonephridia. And this one is the horizontal limb present posteriorly. This is posterior horizontal limb of protonephridia. This anterior vertical limb is a closed structure. It is blind structure. While the posterior horizontal limb, it opens in the atrium by means of opening and this opening is known as nephridiopore. Here you can observe that this dorsal side of this protonephridium as well as the anterior side of this protonephridium, it is a branch structure. It gives several small branches and these branches of protonephridia are known as side branches. And the side branches of this protonephridia, it gives number of phloem cells, near about 500 phloem cells or solenocytes are present in each protonephridia. Let us see the structure and function of solenocyte cells, solenocytes of the protonephridium. This each protonephridium bears about 500 solenocyte. You can observe here number of solenocytes are present on the side branches. For detailed structure of solenocyte, let us enlarge this much portion of the side branch. This is the enlarged structure of side branch. Here you can observe there are number of phloem cells or solenocytes which are present on the dorsal as well as anterior part of this protonephridia. The solenocytes are about 50 mu in length. The solenocyte is divided into basically two part. The rounded tiny portion is the cell body, and long hollow stalk is the tubule of this solenocyte. This cell body bears centrally located nucleus, but it is slightly shifted towards upward direction. Then this cell body also consists of basal body. From the basal body there arises flagellum, this long flagellum which enters into the intracellular lumen of this tubule like this. Now these solenocytes, these are the active part of this protonephridium which takes part in the process of excretion. These nephridia are richly supplied with blood vessels, and this solenocyte, you can see, these freely project into the coelomic fluid. The process of excretion takes place by way of simple diffusion. As this solenocyte, they are freely suspended in the coelomic fluid, in the coelomic canal. The nitrogenous waste are extracted by this solenocyte from the blood. This cell body absorb the nitrogenous waste material, and then it is forwarded through this intracellular lumen of the tubule, and then it reaches to the lumen of side branch of protonephridia. Thus the nitrogenous waste material is collected by means of this solenocyte by the process of simple diffusion. Now this nitrogenous waste material, it comes in this limbs, vertical limbs, posterior, this is horizontal limb. And now the waste material reaches to this position, and through this opening, that is nephridiopore, it is thrown outside this protonephridia. Thus, observe here the position of protonephridia. The excretory product, that is metabolic waste product, are discharged by the opening of this protonephridia, that is nephridiopore, into this cavity of atrium. And along with the current of water, along with outgoing current of water, this nitrogenous waste material is discharged, it is thrown out through this atrial pore outside the body of amphioxus. This is about protonephridia as a excretory organ. Then next excretory organ is Hatchett's nephridium. Hatchett's nephridium lies here in the roof of oral hood. This is the position of Hatchett's nephridium. It is a single, long and straight tube. It is called as nephridium of Hatchett, which lies in the roof of oral hood. The position and structure of this Hatchett nephridium can be clearly understood in this figure. Here is the Hatchett's nephridium. This Hatchett's nephridium is present slightly towards the left and ventral to the notochord. This is the position of notochord, and towards the left of this is Hatchett's nephridium. It is single tube-like structure. The anterior end of this Hatchett's nephridium is blind and it lies somewhat ahead of the Hatchett pits, but the posterior end opens into the prebranchial sac of pharynx. This is the posterior end which opens into prebranchial sac of pharynx. This Hatchett's nephridium is also ectodermal in origin, like that of protonephridia. It is also ectodermal in origin and supplied blood by the dorsal aorta. The structure of this Hatchett's nephridium is basically similar to that of protonephridium as already described. Its surface is covered by a number of solenocytes. These are the solenocytes present on Hatchett's nephridium. And each solenocyte is surrounded by a coelomic sac and extracting nitrogenous waste, thus perform the function of excretion. Then third excretory organ is brown funnel. These brown funnel are two sac-like structure which is situated dorsally upon the posterior end of pharynx. These are the brown funnel which is situated here at the posterior end of the pharynx. The narrow anterior end of each brown funnel opens into the epibranchial or dorsal coelomic canal of its side. This is the narrow end of this brown funnel. And this one is the broad end of brown funnel. This broad posterior end opens into atrium, through which the excretory products are thrown again in the cavity of atrium, which ultimately goes outside the body along with water current. Most worker considered this brown funnel to be excretory, while some scientists regard them to be receptor organs. Then next excretory organ in Amphioxus is renal papillae. These renal papillae are present at the floor of this atrial cavity. These are the renal papillae. It is group of cell present on the floor of atrial cavity from renal papillae, which are probably also excretory in function. Beside these four excretory organs, that is protonephridia, Hatchett's nephridium, brown funnels and renal papillae, again there are group of cells in the atrial wall which also serves the excretory function. Moreover, inside the gonad, especially in testes, elomases are found which contains uric acid, which are expelled with gamete and also plays very important role in removal of nitrogenous excretory metabolites. Thus, we have seen the four main excretory organs in this bronchiostoma, as well as some group of cells which also acts as an excretory organ. So student, here we have finished the information about excretory system of Amphioxus. We will stop here. Thank you. Thank you very much.